How to Give a Performance by William Shakespeare. Speak the speech, I pray you, as I pronounced it to you, trippingly on the tongue. But if you mouth it, as many of our players do, I had as lief the town-crier spoke my lines. Nor do not saw the air too much with your hand, thus, but use all gently, for in the very torrent, tempest, and, as I may say, whirlwind of your passion, you must acquire and beget a temperance that may give it smoothness. Oh, it offends me to the soul, to hear a robustious periwigged fellow tear a passion to tatters, to very rags, to split the ears of the groundlings, who, for the most part, are capable of nothing but inexplicable dumb shows and noise. I would have such a fellow whipped for outdoing termagant. It out-Herods Herod. Pray you avoid it. Be not too tame, either, but let your own discretion be your tutor. Suit the action to the word to the action, with this special observance, that you o'erstep not the modesty of nature. For anything so overdone is from the purpose of playing, whose end, both at the first and now, was and is to hold, as 'twere, the mirror up to nature, to show virtue her own feature, scorn her own image, and the very age and body of the time, his form and pressure. Now this, overdone, or come tardy off, though it may make the unskilful laugh, cannot but make the judicious grieve. The censure of the which one must, in your allowance, o'erweigh the whole theatre of others. Oh, there be players that I have seen play, and heard others praise, and that highly. Not to speak it profanely, that, neither having the accent of Christians, nor the gait of Christian, pagan, nor man, hath so strutted and bellowed, that I have thought some of nature's journeymen had made men, and not made them well. They imitated humanity so abominably.